I will quote something that Bucky said when I first told him I was going to work on this kind of device in the first place. He says, you know, if it works, there's going to be hell to pay. And I said, but we could save the world with this. We could really help everybody with this. And he goes, yes, but there's going to be hell to pay because there's an entire economic power structure that's in place that depends on this not happening. Because it depends on exploiting limited resources and some having the access to them and other people paying a lot of money to get a little bit. I've been poisoned several times. I've been saved by my helpmate several times. I mean, I've literally had no heartbeat. I've had to be injected with antitoxins. I've had a cracked rib one time from people pounding on my from one person pounding on my chest so hard that she got my heart started again. Frivolous lawsuits have been filed that have cost hundreds of thousands of dollars that really should have been going into this research and instead tie you up in court. That's one form of harassment. And that's a very real form of harassment that a lot of people who are trying to do something good find themselves involved in. Our laboratory in Oregon was raided by 13 federal marshals in broad daylight. And everything was confiscated, all the equipment. The replacement value was $23 million. And when the equipment was returned by court order, the charges having no substance, the equipment was ruined and there was no remediation. So to answer your question, none of us had the money to replace the equipment. So what happened to the technology is that it was taken, you know? It was abducted.